OpenAI just leaked GPT 5.1. Thinking in their backend code and Google's Gemini 3 Pro appeared on Vertex AI within the same week. We're talking about two of the biggest AI releases of the year, potentially dropping within days of each other, and the timing feels anything but coincidental. This is about to get interesting. Here's what's happening. Developers digging through ChatGPT's backend found direct references to something called GPT 5.1 Thinking, alongside GPT 5.1 Reasoning and GPT 5.1 Pro. These aren't placeholder names. They're actual model identifiers sitting in OpenAI's production code right now. And the leaked enterprise logs point to a November 24th rollout date, which means we could be looking at a launch window of literally days from now. What makes this different from every other GPT release is right there in the name. Thinking. This isn't about speed or parameter count. It's about reasoning depth. Early indicators suggest GPT 5.1 Thinking uses multi-step reasoning, breaking down complex prompts into smaller components before assembling a complete answer. Think of it like watching someone actually work through a problem instead of just spitting out the first response that comes to mind. OpenAI is apparently introducing something called thinking budgets, where the model allocates more computational time to difficult questions, pausing to reason through ambiguity the way a human would. Now here's where it gets wild. A mysterious model called Polaris Alpha started appearing on OpenRouter around the same time these leaks surfaced. Users testing it noticed performance way beyond GPT-4 level, particularly in creative writing and complex reasoning benchmarks. The consensus in the open source community is that Polaris Alpha is actually GPT 5.1 Thinking running under a different name. If that's true, public access might have already started quietly, which is classic OpenAI stealth rollout strategy. But Google isn't sitting this one out. Gemini 3 Pro just appeared on Vertex AI under the label Gemini 3 Pro Preview 2025, and the timing couldn't be more deliberate. Google's clearly gearing up to intercept OpenAI's launch with their own announcement. Gemini 3 Pro is expected to feature a massive 1 million token context window. That's enough to process entire code bases, full-length books, or massive documents in a single session. Where OpenAI is betting on reasoning depth, Google's betting on scale and memory. The competition between these two approaches is fascinating. OpenAI wants their model to think harder. Google wants their model to remember more. Both are trying to solve the same core problem, making AI feel less like a tool and more like an actual thinking partner. And honestly, both strategies have merit depending on what you're trying to do. Right now, Gemini 2.5 Pro sits at around 67.2% on the SWE verified benchmark using custom agent setups. Claude Sonnet 4.5 is leading at roughly 77.2%. So Google's got ground to cover, and Gemini 3 Pro needs to make a serious leap if they want to compete at the top tier. The expanded context window is part of that strategy, but so is the multimodal reasoning they've been testing. Now let's talk about the surprise wildcard in all of this. Nano Banana 2. If you remember earlier this year, the original Nano Banana absolutely exploded. It let users turn selfies into glossy 3D-style portraits and brought over 10 million new users to Gemini in just a few weeks. It actually helped Gemini surpass ChatGPT in downloads for the first time. Even Jensen Huang from Nvidia called it a breakthrough and joked about going Nano Bananas with it. The sequel is looking seriously impressive. Nano Banana 2 is built on Gemini 3 Pro Image, which is the same architecture powering Gemini's next-generation visual features. We're talking native 2K renders with 4K upscaling, professional-grade quality straight from your phone. But the real upgrade is prompt accuracy. Thanks to improvements in the text-to-image pipeline, you should finally get legible typography in AI-generated posters, UI mockups, and graphics, instead of that weird mangled text we're all used to seeing. One of the most interesting features is cultural context awareness. The model now understands geographic and cultural nuances. So if you type something like streetwear shoot in Berlin winter or family picnic in Tokyo springtime, it generates visuals with regionally accurate lighting, scenery, and fashion details. It's trained on much broader geographic datasets to make outputs feel authentic and localized rather than generic stock photo vibes. Google's also fixing subject consistency, which has been a pain point forever. Earlier models would sometimes change a person's face or outfit between different scenes. Nano Banana 2 keeps characters coherent across multiple prompts, basically turning it into a lightweight visual storytelling tool. Creators working on campaigns or animations can maintain continuity without constantly regenerating everything from scratch. There's also a new Edit with Gemini mode that lets you highlight specific parts of an image to modify instead of regenerating the whole thing. You can tweak outfits, adjust lighting, or swap backgrounds while keeping everything else intact. And the rendering system now completes complex prompts in under 10 seconds, down from 20 to 30 previously. That puts it on par with Midjourney 6 and Adobe Firefly in terms of speed. Under the hood, this all runs on Gemini 3 Pro Image, which is a multimodal architecture that merges image, text, and vision language reasoning. The same backbone powering these creative tools could soon show up in Google Photos, Workspace, and even Android wallpaper generation. Google's planning full integration into Gemini's image panel by early 2026, and there's talk that the Pixel Fold 2 and Pixel 9 Pro will include real-time camera analysis powered by the same model. Meanwhile, Google quietly drops something else that developers are excited about: the Agent Development Kit for Go, or ADK Go. It's part of the same toolkit family supporting Python and Java, but now Go developers get the same capabilities. ADK is Google's open-source framework for building AI agents directly in code rather than relying on visual workflows. It includes out-of-the-box support for over 30 databases and features agent-to-agent communication, letting developers create multi-agent systems where different agents collaborate on tasks without exposing internal memory or proprietary logic. So here's where we're at. OpenAI is about to launch a reasoning-focused model designed to think deeper and handle complexity with more nuance. Google's countering with massive context windows, next-generation image capabilities, and developer tools that make AI integration feel like real software engineering. Both could drop within the same week, maybe even the same day. This isn't just a product launch, it's a full-on strategic duel, and the timing tells you everything. Neither company wants to let the other own the narrative. OpenAI's leaking just enough to build hype. Google's positioning Gemini 3 Pro and Nano Banana 2 as a complete ecosystem update. And we're all watching this unfold in real time. The real winners here are anyone building with AI right now. Competition at this level pushes both companies to ship faster, innovate harder, and actually deliver features people care about instead of incremental tweaks. So whether you're team reasoning depth or team massive context windows, the next few weeks are going to be absolutely wild. This is the AI arms race at full speed. And honestly, it's about time. Make sure to subscribe and hit that like button. And thanks for watching. Catch you in the next one.